Damn, dang, I want to ask you, man, because I remember 20 plus years ago when Aaliyah died, and it actually, I shed a few tears, bro. I'm not even going front. But what is one of your finest moments of Aaliyah? And did y'all have talks about doing business together and possibly she being under you, signed to you? Was that ever a conversation? And what do you think she would be doing right now? I feel like she would be the biggest artist in the world.
Our talks were how to have her do her own shit.
Okay.
And, you know, I would always be there to make sure she did it right. You know?
Okay.
Like, for example, she really liked Freeway a lot. So the reason why I was actually in Miami was because she was supposed to jump on a record with Freeway. She came in the studio and all that. So she was always like a real team player. And if she was inspired, it was always, you know, it wasn't about politics for her. You know, so basically we would have just organically been creating. And our talks were more about what she was going to do in the future, you know, because she had a lot going on.
Right.
It wasn't like she was trying to do anything. She was doing it. She was about to be in Matrix. She was shooting movies, you know.
Damn, she was about to be in the Matrix?
Yeah. While she was shooting that other movie, she flew, and she was supposed to be in the Matrix, that next Matrix. I forgot who took her spot. I think Marvin Gaye's daughter, right? Maybe.
Marvin Gaye's daughter. Yep.
She like the right people in the right places were already aware of her in fashion, in movies, and music.
Right.
And it was just, she had really big things going on, and she was the coolest girl, for real, for real.
Right.
She really was. That's why I know I'm the coolest, because she told me. That's when I like, oh, I know I'm the coolest. I was with Aaliyah. You know what I'm saying? Period.
Right. Absolutely.
So, good. And, you know, it was really just more about love. It was the times that we were alone were the best. You know what I mean? And that's all we wanted to do was be alone. It was like, it wasn't a thing where we enjoyed being in front of people.
Mm-hmm.
And we never showcased our relationship in public. Most people didn't really know until, you know, she wasn't here anymore. Because we respected more than anything our fun. So we would go places where there was nobody. Mm-hmm. And those would be our best times. You know what I mean? Where we just, you know, we could just. I mean, I remember when I was shooting Paid in Full.
Mm-hmm.
And she flew in to L.A. for the Matrix thing from Australia for one day.
This is to be with you.
Well, no, she went to I'm going to tell you. She was coming in to L.A. for one day to go see the Matrix, you know, because she was shooting a movie, but to go see the Matrix people, the same producers that produced that movie.
Okay.
And I was shooting that part and paid in full that, you know, we get more money than you and da-da-da.
Right.
Report to the bridge for blow up. Yeah. And after that, I ran, got on a flight, and we flew in. I flew in to see her just for that one night and flew right back the next day to shoot Paid in Full. Because, you know, I really didn't have the time to fly 25 hours to Australia. So I was like, fuck it. I just go there and back. That's way better.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's how it was. Or, like, I remember we were someplace and someone offered us a private jet, you know, to get on a private jet with them to go someplace. And we chose to get on a regular plane, because that's what we could just, you know, we didn't really want to talk to nobody. You know what I mean? It was like we just did anything to be alone. You know what I mean? To just kick it. We just enjoyed company. Like again, with Aaliyah, with what she taught me, because I was in love and I never knew what being in love would feel like to her. Mm-hmm. And I thought that I would never feel that again.
Right.
But once I got with Raquel and felt that same feeling,
mm-hmm.
I was able to recognize that to how to treat Raquel and move forward in our relationship. Mm. And I know Aaliyah guided me in that direction.
Right.
Because I know she wouldn't want me to be alone all these years without her.
Right. That's deep, man. Because you know what makes me think about sometimes one relationship gets you ready for the other relationship. And I feel like when I listen to you talk, that's what happened with Aaliyah. She got you ready for your future. Even though she died the way she died, she still got you ready for your future. So her presence is still felt in the way you think about a woman.
Right. And even to the thing, like, I'm not trying to fall ever in love with, like, a singer or an actress, because they be gone all the time. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, with Raquel, she's a professional. Dude.
Right.
We're doing everything together.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody going to benefit and be in her company because of her art but me.
Right.
At least no men. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So,
yeah.
You know, being a celebrity, you got to deal with a lot of shit.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to be with a celebrity to understand that. That's why celebrities be with celebrities, because they're used to being on the road all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But right. When you have a girl and you love her, you want to be with your girl all the time when you're really in love.
That's true.
Like, I'm really in love. Like, I don't be wanting, you know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
You know?
Yeah.
Real. So, like, I don't see how a nigga be in love or with a woman and she's mm-hmm. gone four months out the year, and you just, because I'm sick when I'm not with my girl. You know what I mean? So,
right.
You know, if I'm at a hotel, that's why I don't even stay. You got to come with me. I'm like, I don't even feel none of that shit. But that was her right there. I didn't even know right. She was, where she came from. Got a massage, see?
Man, you see, know? Man, that's what it's all about, man. You know, love. That's what this world need, Dane. This world need love, bro.
That's why I'm showing it. You know, and I'm very transparent about it. Because if you go your whole life, if I'd have went my whole life,
mm-hmm.
and I wasn't able to have a baby with a woman that I am with,
yeah.
I would have missed everything. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
But, like, you know, I've been with her for, like, a decade and shit. And I'm like, damn, it's people that got to get up. Like, during the pandemic, it wasn't nothing, because it was just us, like we always be.
Yeah. So,
like, damn, now we really can hang out. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
she really,
exactly.
So that's yeah. what it became.
Right.
You know? Right. And I just remember, like, I remember... When I knew I was in love with Aaliyah, was because she was going on that movie,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't even know, and you know, like, it was gonna hit me like that, and it was 4 months, and you know, we were saying bye and shit. She started crying and she left, and I started crying. I was like, I'm crying. I can't believe this. So I don't want to be in that position where
right.
I'm down low crying and shit because I miss my girl. And
yeah.
niggas don't act like y'all don't be crying when y'all miss your girl. You know what I'm saying? Babies,
tell them,
like,
Dane,
you know what I mean? Like,
tell them, Dane, stop living
months.
A facade, nigga. Stop living a facade. It's already just shed a couple tears.
Yeah, that
nigga.
Shit ain't tough.
Niggas always want
to
be tough.
If you don't have the ability to love, you ain't tough.
Right.
The toughest niggas is the most sensitive ones on the low. You know what I mean? That's why they be overreacting.
Tell them, Dane, you dropping gems on them tonight, bro.